side of the pop, kind of loosen the roof all up, so it's not adhering, and then you want to get a strong guy. Strong guy. You want to pull it out, okay, and you want to roll it over to the hole, and if you see any roots on the side, they look like they need to be... Okay, you got that a circular there. Roof. Yeah. Does anybody got a razor knife? I got a knife, I'll find
it. With a shovel,
no? Or a shovel, right, you can use a shovel. But if you see the roots coming out, they come out to the side of the pot, and they're starting to circulate around, you want to kind of open them up. So when they go on the ground, they'll move out this way instead of around in the circular pattern of the roof ball.
You try to cut that, Steve?
I would cut that. Yeah, that's less than a third of the size of the and what you want to do is when you put it in the ground, you want the tree to be resting in the hole so that the top of the root ball is either flush with or about an inch or two above the surrounding grade. You don't want to pile dirt. You want to dig the hole so deep that the top of the grade is going to go over the plant. And you're going to cover up the root ball. This is the oxygen-water interface, which is a fancy way of saying this is where the water comes in, this is where the roots aerate, one of the main places where they aerate. So you want to make sure that you leave this free from soil. You don't want to bury it too deep. You want to bury it about an inch above the surrounding grade. And then when you backfill, what you want to do is you want to gently tamp the soil in. Okay, you might want to tamp the soil on the bottom of the hole so the tree will settle less and it won't go deeper than it should. And then you want to go ahead and put it in the hole, backfill, start tamping the soil gently, okay, and then you water in, and when you water, of course, we're not watering, but if you are at home or in another event and they have water, you want to water to eliminate all the air pockets, okay, in between the side of the hole and the root ball, because if air contacts the roots directly, it's very detrimental.
We're not having mulch today?
We have mulch, okay, and the mulch is going to be very simple. We have two cubic yard bags or cubic foot bags of mulch. We basically want to mulch from the edge of the planting pit, about 2 inches back from the base of the tree. You never want to pile mulch up against the base of the tree. It creates an environment that's not good for the tree. It creates a damp environment where pathogens, bacteria, and fungus may thrive and create a problem on the stem of the tree. So that's pretty basic stuff. I'm sure everyone's got this. If they haven't gotten it now, they've had it before, right? Are we all good?
We're going to take care of it.